Those against it say nay. The ayes have it. Who will I refer to?
I represent the people of Chikun Kajubeda Constituency. I'm from Kaduna State. Mr. Speaker, I come under Rule 8. I come under Order 846, matter of urgent public importance.
Silence, please. Order. Honorable members, order, please.
Mr. Speaker, the matter which I think is very urgent and public.
Order, please. Honorable members, please.
Environmental hazard that is affecting my people in Chikun local government. And this has to do with illegal mining activities. The issue is so important, I consider, and I want with the leave of this house so that we can suspend the relevant rules so that
order,
this issue will be listened to. As I talk to you, Mr. Speaker, and honorable colleagues, a village in my constituency has become
honorable
a security
Gudaji.
Threat.
Honorable Gudaji, Kazaure, please go back to your seat. Kazaure.
Influx of people who I believe are not Nigerians but are in the country just to participate in activity which is illegal and which is detrimental to the health of my people. So I want with the leave of the House so that the House Order 46 Rule 6 will be suspended so that I will take this motion and consider it important. So with the leave of the House, Mr. Speaker, I pray that this issue will be taken as important and also the relevant section of our rules will be suspended so that I take this motion. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Any seconder to the first limb of the
motion? I rise to second the motion as moved by Minority Whip. I so second.
Those in favor of the motion?
I rise to second the second leg of the prayer. I so second.
Illegal mining activities at Damba settlement in Remi village, Pulku district, Chikun local government area of Kaduna state. The House note that sometimes in February 2016, some youth reported the activities of illegal expatriates and local miners improperly mining lead contaminated gold ore in Tadna river across Damba settlement in Remi village of Chikun local government of Kaduna state. Aware of the grave environmental devastation and health hazard associated with artisan mining, worried about the influx of illegal miners from across our national borders and from within the area with its attendant security implication, recognizing the need for coordinated and proper harnessing of natural resources, the House do resolve, call on the Minister of Environment, Ministry of Solid Minerals, and the Inspector General of Police to immediately take steps to secure the already identified site with a view to halting the illegal mining activities that may cause devastating environmental and health hazards. Two, call on the Minister of Solid Minerals to carry out detailed studies of the site and its environs to determine the commercial availability and viability of gold ore prospecting in the area. I so move, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I so move, Mr. Speaker. I must thank our members for allowing me to bring this motion. And it is very important to me because this has to do with the health of our people. Mr. Speaker, if you remember, sometimes ago in 2010, there was this report of illegal mining in Zamfara State. And it was reported that nearly 163 people died from lead poisoning. And also, we had a reported case of nearly 400 people who were born or who were already alive but had health problems. Mr. Speaker, we all know that in mining, you can never say what you are going to get. And the moment you start mining, it is possible you get in touch with lead. And lead ore is very poisonous. And you get in touch with it whether through water or through contact. And it has the residual effect on our children, because people that have come in contact with lead, at the end of the day, if the woman is pregnant, it affects the children are born with deficiencies, with disabilities, and so on. So, Mr. Speaker, apart from the health hazard, you agree with me during this period when we are trying to make sure that the security of the nation is protected. Now, in this village I'm talking about, we have people who I'm very sure, because I was able to send people, my aides, to go to that village. And Mr. Speaker, I don't have it in authority, but these people that were there, which they saw, were not Nigerians. Were people from Chad, Niger, and neighboring countries. And you know the porous nature of our borders today. People come into the country, do illegal business in our country, even cause security problems to us. So, Mr. Speaker and honorable colleagues, I think this is the time for our country, Nigeria, to really look inward. We are talking of diversification of economy. We are talking of moving away from a mono economy where we are depending on oil. And today we have this large deposit of resources in different parts of the country. And we have left it in the hands of quacks, in the hands of people who do not wish this country well, because they came into the country, all they are interested in, they don't care what else happens to the environment, whether they will leave the environment with pools that are dangerous to our animals, dangerous to people. We are aware of people getting drowned in Plateau State, in Benue State, because of these abandoned pits that were dug by illegal miners. Mr. Speaker, these pits are not useful today to Nigeria. They cannot be used. And Mr. Speaker, as I talk to you today, the pits I saw in that villages are so deep, and the repercussion is what happened to that land. Can that land be farmed again? Will it be useful to the people? The answer is no. So why should we continue to allow these very good resources, which has the high potential of earning income for the country, to be lying waste and allows people that are not expert to be the one doing this business? So, Mr. Speaker, I want us, this House, to agree with me that these areas, a proper coordinated effort should be made so that we secure these areas. The Minister of Soil and Minerals can take a study and find out the viability in terms of commercial quantity of this area, so that expatriates could be coordinated, who will come in and invest in our solid mineral sector so that we can earn foreign earning. Mr. Speaker, I so move, and I pray that the House will support this.